Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1827. Read selected auto filter values. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today, a great question sent in by Mark G. He originally posted this at Google+. He has a column with an auto filter outside the print range that he's using to show only certain rows in a report. He wants to get the selected items from that auto filter column back into the report. Is there a formula or something like that? Well, I don't think there's a formula. Well, hang on. Maybe there's a formula. You could use equal subtotal or equal aggregate to check and see if the count of each individual cell is one. In other words, is it visible? Never mind. I'm just going to go straight to VBA. Maybe Mike Gervin could do that, but let's go straight to VBA. So as I started to think about this, you know, there's lots of different ways to auto-filter data, and AutoFilter has improved over the years. It's just called Filter now, but in VBA it's called AutoFilter, so I'm going to keep doing that. You know, it would be bad if you went in and selected certain dates because they have all of these items that were added. And so if you happen to be watching this video at YouTube because you searched for this and you have a date column, or if you used some sort of a custom value column like between or something like that, you're going to have a different situation. I'm assuming we just have some text and we're going in and selecting one or two or more items from the text and want to know what's selected and report that up here in the report. That's what I'm assuming. So when I started to investigate this, first thing I wanted to do is I wanted to see how the macro recorder records that action. So turn on the macro recorder and say how to filter. We turn on the filters, go to column G over here and just select 1, 2, 3 items, click OK. All right, stop recording. Let's go look at that code. Alt F8, how to filter, edit. All right, so they do selection.autofilter, and then they're using field 6. So even though column G is the 7th column, it's the 6th column in the data. And then criteria 1, they're passing an array to criteria 1. Operator is Excel filter values. All right, so I know a little bit about using autofilter. There's always a criteria 1. Often there's an operator, but not always. And sometimes there's a criteria 2. So we're kind of lucky here in this case where we're selecting text items. We only have to worry about criteria 1 to see what's in there, although it's an array that's in there. I did go out to Excel Help on the autofilter where they had this code, and I thought it was interesting code, useful code, because it showed that they are checking to see if the worksheet.autofilter.filters.item and then item 6, if the dot on is true, that tells us if anything is selected in that filter. They also looked at dot criteria 1 and checked to see if dot operator before they looked at the operator in criteria 2. So if you have one of those other situations where it's dates or a custom filter, you're going to have to possibly use those. But in my case, the code that we used was, I think, simpler. Although, as time went on, this got more and more complex. Let's ignore these cases right here for now and just deal with the start. That assumes that the auto filter is turned on and something is selected from column 6. So we start out dim WS as a worksheet, dim filter array as an array variable. So we don't know how many items are going to be in there, but we specify just a blank set of parentheses there. That way it will expand as needed. And then set WS equal to the active sheet. And then use ws.autofilter.filters6. That's the 6th column. Even though it's the 7th column in the spreadsheet, it's the 6th column in the autofilter. And used .criteria1. Remember, that's how it got recorded down here. .criteria1 was equal to an array. So we're taking whatever's in criteria 1 and assigning it to this filter array variable. Now, the problem is we don't know how many items are in the filter array, so we use this cool function, I guess, UBound stands for upper bound, and in this case, if I selected 3 items, UBound will be equal to 3. All right, so we're going to run this code. Let's make sure that we have a few items selected. Yep, and I'm going to stop it right here. This caused an error the first time that I ran it because each of those items are in the filter array with an equal sign. See that? Equal hurricane. And when you write that into the spreadsheet, it thinks that there's a named range called hurricane and you get a reference error or something like that. So because of that, I had to use the mid of my text starting at position 2 for a length of how many. That gets rid of the leading equal sign. I could have done that in all one statement, of course, using the mid right there, but I wanted to show you that interim result. I'll go ahead and let this finish running. Hurricane, rainy, and windy. And then if we change to something else, click OK, click Update Titles, it will run there. Okay, a couple of things. We had to handle the case where there was nothing selected, so it's just left in its default state, and you'll see in the code I had to check if not ws.autofilter.filters.6.on, so that's a true false thing. If that's not true, then we just write all. Also the chance that we have not turned the autofilters on at all. So if ws.autofilter is nothing, oh, that's an interesting statement. I don't think I've used that in the podcast before. That's a word to say, here's an object variable. If this has not yet been created, if it doesn't exist yet, the words for that are is nothing. Then we write, let's write no filter applied, or filter's not turned on. And instead of all down here, we'll write, all right, so a couple of tests. Turn the filters off, update titles, filters not turned on. Turn the filter on, but don't select anything from item 6, everything's selected. And then the other one to be aware of, let's turn on sunny and raining and hurricane. Click OK, what a weird combination, and click update titles. It shows us that, but then if later on we would filter another column, take the 0 out of head 1, now sunny is no longer here. It's not even in the list anymore, but it's still secretly selected behind the scenes. I know that because when I run the macro, they continue to show sunny as one of the items. So just be aware of that. The other thing that was frustrating to me is I said, hey, this update titles would be really good if we could just run this every time I chose from the filter. But there does not seem to be a worksheet event macro. So selection change, none of these are getting fired when we just change something from the auto filter dropdown. So worksheet change there, if I come here and type 1, it runs the macro. But if all I do is open the filter dropdown and change what's selected, that does not fire that. So that's why I had to add the shape here, right click, assign macro. I had to manually assign that macro to the button. Hey, I want to thank Mark for posting that question, and I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.